Please stand for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Tigers.
It's Tuesday, March 17th, and it's still an A day.
Remember when Star Center showed up at a girls' basketball game?
I do. How could we forget?
On the 18th of February, Lucas Coles, Kobe Nichols, Isaac Johnson, Michael Antonelli, and Blake Williams joined together at the girls' basketball game to act as ESPN sideline reporters.
I was just playing 2K, and I get a text from Kobe, and Kobe sent me a picture of another town doing this, but it obviously wasn't as good as ours. And they were like, he was like, bro, we need to do this. I was like, yeah, let's do it, I guess. I don't know. And so, yeah, here we are.
I think the reason why we did this was because Katie kind of showed me the idea of it, of another student section doing it. So I kind of decided, like, hey, why don't I get a few of the guys together, see if they want to go do it with me. And then they said yes, so we planned it out and decided to do it.
These reporters were hoping their act would help bring up their team spirit.
Yeah, I think it really helped them out to play better, just be a little more hyped up because they just knew the whole squad was there to help them out there repping, wanting them to play a good game.
I think it just brought more energy to the crowd, gave them a little bit more confidence because they knew we were all watching them and just having fun.
I think we could do it next year. We're talking about probably doing it next year. But it would have to be Kobe's last year because he's graduating.
And we've thought about maybe even doing it for different sports. We can always do volleyball, or we'll do basketball probably again once more.
We don't have any announcements for today.
This is it.
The FFA co-op test plot meeting is today from 3:30 to 4 o'clock in the high school ag room.
They will be discussing this year's crop experiment. Go see what that group is about.
For GM97, I'm Danny Johnson.
And I'm Genesis Cernick.
Have a great day, Tigers.
Bye. What the?
Sorry.
When you think of your mental health journey, what comes to mind?
What a question. I think when people hear remember to take care of your mental health, they think that everyone else is, and that's not at all accurate, you know? For me, I'm trying to learn still to make sure that I stay okay, you know what I'm saying? But I just answered like 40 questions in one.
That's great.
Wait a minute. It doesn't make you weak to ask for help. It doesn't. It doesn't make you weak to ask for a friend, to go to a therapist. It shouldn't make you feel weak to ask anyone for help, and you should be able to ask anyone for help, and everyone has to help someone if they need it.
You know, starting that conversation, you don't have to make it super serious right away. You know, you say, how are you feeling? Like, are you okay? Are you okay? Ask somebody. That's what they, you know, and yeah, I'm good. Really? You know, are you actually good? Like, sometimes you don't even have to say anything to someone for them to know they understand. And they don't have to say anything to you. Sometimes it's about a hug. It's about somebody holding you and telling you, not even telling you anything, that's what I'm saying. Holding you. The main thing I'm trying to say is that you should keep your ears open and you should listen. And I'm just dealing with it how I'm dealing with it, and I'm trying my best. Obviously, I'm not a trained professional in anything. I don't know what I'm doing half the time. But I have seen it, and I've been it. And even if it's just a little bit more comfort, that can really mean a lot to someone. Because you don't know what is going on. Even in that moment, there could be something going on, and it's been like that for me. There have been certain people that have texted me right when I needed to be texted, you know, saying they loved me and that they were thinking about me. And it really means a lot,